Hello, everyone, and welcome to a series of re-reviews. That's right. We've looked at these units before, and we are now going to take a brand new look at them in a new series of videos. And why? Well, honestly, some things have changed here on the JB side, and one of the biggest things is that Magic True Dual Hand is a thing. Now, it's not super available to everyone yet. I do admit that it is behind an EX point unit, which does cost money. But eventually we will see Magic True Dual Hand become a thing where everyone can get it. I imagine Sorceress Ultmisia as well as God Kafka will probably have some kind of TMR that deal with Magic True Dual Hand. It's still new to the game and it is potentially incredibly powerful. So these are all units that we have done reviews for in the past, but we are now going to take a look at them under new light, which basically comes from the fact that Magic True Dual Hand is a thing. So, for now, let's cue the music, and I'm going to start introducing the first unit we will be taking a re-review at. So the reason that I chose this music is because, honestly, this unit is rather important to me. This is a unit that I have kind of had just been using for, like, what feels like forever. This unit was one of my first really big 5-stars on the JP side, and she has been absolutely indispensable for 6 out of 8 weeks in every arena cycle. She just does so much damage, her chaining is absolutely insane, and she has some really damn good stats. But as it turns out, she has some more incredible stats now that I can build her just a little bit better. Also, fair warning, this build is super, super TMR heavy. So the first one today we are going to be taking a, well, the first in this series of videos we're going to be taking a look at is Runera. And I'll take you, I mean, that's a pretty beautifully statted Runera. 7,397 HP, and she can still have about another 500 points worth of HP pots put in. 593 MP, and she can have more MP. 400 attack. 291 for defense. A little soft there, but we can put in some more defense to her. 969 for spirit, which is pretty damn impressive. But of course, the big one is her magic stat. 2,691. The highest magic stat in the game that I am aware of. I'm pretty sure I don't know of anything higher. Now, something to note too is that Runera doesn't have that high of a base magic stat. Unlike Elly or Ultima, who have the highest base magic stats in the game, and also put more magic points into it from basically the, you know, the 65 points that they can put in over Runera. Runera has a much more balanced out limit burst, stat pot. But she has so many passives in her kit, and such a big boost to her spirit and her magic from being able to, from just so many passives. And to be honest, probably could still get a better build out of the weapon raid for her TMR too. So that's kind of exciting. But here we also see Super TMR, Super TMR, Super TMR. When I rebuild all the other units too, they will basically have the same equipment so that we can see the differences between them. And hopefully in the near future, I can get my fourth one of these, which I think should put her over the 2700. But still, come on, you guys. This is pretty insane. This is absolutely insane for a magic style. Now, the one thing is Runera's abilities can't be double casted or anything like that, but if there's a magic parameter mission that's even 2500 magic, I can basically do it right away. Whoops, wrong party. Pretend that didn't happen. Pretend. But we'll take a look at Runera's chaining. Now, normally it can do about 14 million points of damage between two Runeras. And keep in mind that I only have one Runera at this high of a magic stat. The other one is not. So, we're going to need some help from Ignis. Keep our MP high and try and get some chaining damage in. Also, the other thing I really like about Runera is that she has a really strong chaining. ability, or it's great for building limit bursts. It's fantastic for being chained into, especially if you have the same element on the weapon. So let's take a look. 38 million points of damage just from their chain with no debuffing or buffing whatsoever. Now let's get some Sid love down here. Whoops, hit the wrong button. It happens. Sometimes it just, you know, the guy comes down prematurely. Would have been more if we had chained into it. Hey, let's do it again, right? Why not? But Runera's chaining is very, very strong and great for clearing out a ton of story events, trial events, all of that kind of stuff. It's reliable chaining too, also because it doesn't use a ton of MP. And Runera gets, you know, quite a bit of MP. So now let's just bring down the Sid. Some nice damage there for sure. Now we will buff and get ready for the next turn. $214 million. Runera's chaining is really, really great. And yes, Kanshira and Nagi both come along, and Lorraine as well, who have the same type of chaining that is essentially double casted because they are dual wield units. I fully admit that is a big, 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 big strength. So let's try it with the wind debuff. The other thing I want to show off is with 150% boost, it boosts her magic over 3,000. Pretty damn highly statted. Okay, let's go. Should be a nice 59 chain, yes. 67, roughly 67 million points. Now, obviously not as strong as probably two highly statted Axstars doing it together, but again, remember, one of my Runeras is not, and Runera doesn't have quite as high passive. She is, you know, a pretty old unit in the game. But the fact that she can just be so highly statted is kind of cool. Sometimes these old units definitely do have very, very long-term value. And I still use Runera pretty much every week in Arena that I can. She has been such a fantastic support. She has been kind of the linchpin of so many of my cool videos, especially the CG Sid videos. So giving her an extra review, even if it's a short one, Runera, I'm always gonna love you, babe. So thank you very much for watching, and next time we'll take a look at yet another mage that will benefit from true dual hand magic. I think next time we'll take a look at another really good friend of mine, CG Sakura, who, I mean, invaluable for beating Odin 3-star and Leviathan 3-star. It's a good trip down memory lane. I will see you all in the next re-review in this true dual hand mage meta.